SN1 reaction mechanism. Here, SN1 stands for substitution. Substitution nucleophilic unimolecular reaction. We'll discuss about each and every word little bit later. Now here in SN1 reaction, you can see the tertiary butyl bromides react with the alkali such as sodium hydroxide or potassium hydroxide, and it gets converted into tertiary butyl alcohol. In order to study the mechanism of this reaction, first consider the kinetics of this reaction. If you see the rate of this reaction, it depends only on the concentration of tertiary butyl bromide and not the aqueous NaOH or any alkali used in this particular reaction. So let us write the rate equation for this reaction. Rate of this reaction is directly proportional to the concentration of tertiary butyl bromide. This indicates that the overall reaction completed in two steps. Means in the first step, whatever we have, the tertiary butyl bromide, it undergoes the change in the concentration, and that particular step is important in the determination of the rate of the reaction. So let us write the first step. So I will write here as a step 1. In case of step 1, we have starting material, that is tertiary butyl bromide. So I will write here tertiary butyl bromide like that. We have bromine. When this tertiary butyl bromide ionizes, at that time we get the very important intermediate, that is carbocation. So here we can write CH3. We have CH3, and here we have CH3. This carbocation is sp3 hybridized carbocation. It means that it is planar in nature. So simultaneously we have Br-. Overall, this particular step is very slow step. So I will write here as a slow step. Again, we have the second step. So in step 2, this carbocation reacts with the nucleophile, that is OH-. So let me write again the carbocation CH3. When this carbocation reacts with OH-, so I will write here as a OH-. This overall reaction is very fast reaction, fast step, and finally we get the tertiary butyl alcohol. So here we have CH3, OH. Out of these two steps, the slow step is rate determining step. So I will write here as a rate determining step. It indicates that out of these two steps, the first step is important in determination of the rate of this particular reaction. And also we can give the evidence for this particular rate determining step with the help of energy profile diagram of the SN1 reaction. This is the energy profile diagram of SN1 reaction. We have a starting reactants over here. So let me write here as a reactant. And finally, here we get products. The energy profile diagram of SN1 mechanism shows why rate of reaction is independent of the concentration of nucleophile, that is NaOH. The first step requires large activation energy, that is delta E1. Here you can see. Then that of the second step, that is E delta E2. So here you can compare these activation energies. The first step to form carbocation determines the rate of overall reaction. In the first step, at this stage, we have carbocation. So I can write carbocation like this over here. The intermediate carbocation appears at a low point in the diagram. You can see in this particular diagram, the conditions and reagents which favors the formation of carbocation will accelerate the SN1 reaction. Now here you can see that this is the energy difference between the reactants and the products, and this energy difference is known as the heat of reaction or delta H. So it is known as heat of reaction. So it means that we have two transition states in this energy profile diagram, and this gives evidence that the rate of this reaction depends upon the only tertiary butyl bromide and not the alkali.